of hope and expectations of God being faithful to us. It doesn't matter what you've done, where you've been at, and what's been done to you. We serve a powerful God that transcends everything. There's nothing, He's not captivated in a time that He cannot do anything for us. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore.
Amen.
And He makes His presence real tonight for the very purpose of reaching anyone that does not know the Lord Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Maybe many times you've turned your face to the wall. And didn't wait on God to speak to you. And because of the negative things that were said, the things that were done, seemed to be so overwhelming that we thought there was no answer. But it's in a night like tonight that an answer can come to the voice of God's selected angels. You know, in Scripture, John in Revelation, we call the pastors of the church, angels of the church, to the angel of the church of Ephesus, to the angel of the church of covenant restoration, to the angel of the church of the life center. And He sends messages such as this to touch the heart of people and bring them to the realization not only will God give you 15 years, He'll give you eternal life. So if tonight you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, I'm just going to do like we always do in services. We all are going to repeat the sinner's prayer. Just repeat after me. Because I want to make sure we cover everyone. I want to make sure that we cover everyone. Because I don't want to stand before the presence of God one day and the Lord will remind me when my son, Pastor Thomas, was preaching at your church at the Life Center that you didn't make an altar call or make an opportunity for the sinner's prayer. And one of mine was never redeemed. But I'm going to cover that. I'm going to blanket it all tonight in Jesus' name. So just repeat after me. Even though you know the Lord Jesus Christ, for the benefit of someone who may be here tonight that is not saved. Jesus Christ, repeat after me. Lord, tonight I stand before your presence.
I stand before your presence.
I've heard your word.
I've heard your word.
Your anointed word.
Your anointed word.
It has stirred my spirit.
It has stirred my spirit.
Has brought conviction.
Brought conviction.
Correction.
Correction.
And tonight, I open my mouth in confession
that I am a sinner
needing redemption
needing salvation
needing the blood of Jesus
to cleanse me
of all my sins. So at this moment, Lord, I accept you
as my Lord and Savior.
I acknowledge that I am saved. And from this moment forward, I have eternal life. I give you all the honor.
And glory.
In your precious name I pray. Amen. Give the Lord a praise.